Hallihallo Leute, hier bin ich wieder, eure liebe kleine Dodo, mit dem dritten Gameplay von Life is Strange. Ich habe jetzt mal so ein bisschen geguckt, was ich noch alles für euch auf Lager habe. Also, gucken wir uns erstmal das an.
At least switch to E6.
Und dann gucken wir uns mal die Graffiti an.
Oh, that's not nice. Poor little otter.
Also ich mache bis zum bitteren Ende, damit ihr auch sehen könnt, wofür ich mich zum Schluss entschieden habe. Deshalb, es werden noch einige Videos kommen. Alle, wie gesagt, so um die 45 Minuten. Ich will hoffen, dass es euch trotzdem gefällt, auch wenn ich nicht großartig viel rede.
They sure get a lot of mileage out of otter power.
Und hauptsächlich das Spiel eigentlich nur läuft. Wenn es euch doch nicht gefallen sollte, schreibt es bitte in die Kommentare.
Otter power? I'm so not there.
Damit ich Bescheid weiß, dass ich nochmal so ein Gameplay nicht mache. Also wie gesagt, ich ziehe das jetzt durch bis zum Spielende. Und wenn ich weiß, es ist doch nicht so euer Ding, mache ich auch kein Gameplay mehr. Dann lass es bei den Let's Plays.
I'm sure this poster has stopped millions of bullies.
Ich schaue mich jetzt einfach hier nochmal so ein bisschen auf dem Schulhof um, bevor ich dann quasi zurück zu Warren gehe, um ihm den USB-Stick zu geben. Deshalb also nicht irritieren lassen. Ich laufe noch mal so ein bisschen durch die Gegend, quatsche noch mal mit ein paar Leuten, damit man auch quasi so ein bisschen mit den Leuten quatscht und die Erfahrung sammelt und ein paar Informationen sammelt.
Warren's waiting for me and his flash drive in the parking lot, so I better get back to my dorm. Now I have to go back to the dorm. This day never ends. Hi, Brooke.
Let me guess. You want to fly my drone?
I'd love to. I love planes and balloons and...
This is neither. Do you know what a drone really is?
A weapon, right?
You read too many conspiracy sites. This might be too complicated for you. Funny. Warren said you were smart. Please. Step back.
I'm almost sure Warren has the same bag. It looks a bit nerdy, though. I don't want to go that way. Clever. That's Luke Parker. Zachary pushed him into a locker last week.
Hello?
Max, I don't feel like talking.
Oh, sorry. I won't bother you.
I need to go there and grab Warren's flash drive. Evan's portfolio always looks so uber pro. I'd love to see his photos in there.
Hey, Evan. Mind if I check out your cool portfolio?
Let's see if you're worthy of it, Max. You'll have to answer a simple question. Who photographed the famous falling soldier?
Isn't it Robert Dorneau?
Oh my. You can't even tell the difference between street photography and photojournalism. No portfolio peek for you.
That's one of his famous shots. I love how it captures the moment.
Nach langem Umgucken und viel Quatschen mit den Leuten gehe ich jetzt mal auf den Weg zu Warren. Ich würde einfach mal sagen, guckt euch die kleine Videofrequenz an. Und dann werdet ihr sehen, was auf euch zukommt.
I'm glad I stepped in that time. Can't stand to see people being bullied.
I don't get it. How could Zack and Victoria do that to me?
Hi, Juliet. How are you doing?
Oh, hey, Max. Sorry, I'm still screwed up.
Sorry you had to find out about Zachary that way. Or anyway.
Better sooner than later. Now that skank Victoria won't be laughing behind my back anymore.
Have you talked to Zack yet?
Mr. Badass Football Hero is such a chicken shit. He said he sexted Victoria as a joke. Ha ha. I think Warren wants your attention.
He usually does. Hang in there, Juliet.
See you around, Max.
I wonder how long before Samuel has to repaint that. Good thing I don't have a car. Yet. Who toilet papers a bike? The whole town is turning into one giant missing persons poster. Damn, somebody is seriously devoted to putting up these posters. That dog looks peaceful asleep, but if I get too close, Cujo.
Come on over here, please.
Look at Warren in his Wayback Machine. He's a brave man.
What up, Max? How are you?
Here's your flash. Thanks.
No problem. Check out my new wheels.
Cool. Very old school.
1978, to be exact. Now we can go to the drive-in. There's one in Newburgh just 60 miles away.
You're in the wrong time, Warren. But then, so am I.
You okay?
It's been one strange fucking day.
I bet. I heard Victoria got a face full of paint. I'd pay money to see a photo of that.
Really? I wish I would have known.
You probably could have raised a Kickstarter fund just for that one image of her covered in paint.
Had I known that. Anyway, Victoria took down my photo, so that drama ended well.
By the way, I saw Daniel's sketch of you online. Not bad, but I could do a much better job.
You can draw? I thought you were blinded by science, not art.
Art is science. Music is math, etc., etc. I'd put Stephen Hawking against Picasso any day.
Hardcore. So you must use a computer to draw?
Of course. I'd love to tweak one of your selfies with some cool graphics.
That might not suck. I'll let you know.
So, did you get a chance to check out the movie booty on my flash drive?
Yeah, thanks. You had some cool shit on there, from Akira to Twilight Zone, which seems apropos today.
I consider myself a pop cultural pirate connoisseur.
That does sound better than thief.
Ha ha. Make sure you watch Cannibal Holocaust.
seen it. I was more disturbed by all those emo vampire movies in there.
Can a sensitive high school boy love sensitive vampires too?
So you're sensitive.
Ouch, that sounds awful the way you say it.
How so?
Sensitive usually means won't be having sex with you.
Oh God, you need a sensitive woman to kick your ass.
If I was lucky. Speaking of hip and fast, we should cruise out in my car to an actual movie this week. But you seem distracted.
I need to talk to somebody, just to get it out of my system.
Dr. Warren Graham is in the house. I won't even prescribe you any meds. Tell me everything.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me, not social media.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
I had this incredibly bizarro experience in Mr. Jefferson's class today. I mean, life-changing. Have you ever had a dream so real it was like a movie?
Max Caulfield, right? You're one of the Jefferson's photo groupies?
I'm one of his students.
What the fuck ever? I know you like to take pictures, especially when you're hiding out in the bathrooms. You best tell me what you saw, now. Answer me, bitch!
What are you talking about?
I know you're new here, but don't even play stupid with me.
I'm not new. I've lived here for years.
Then you should know the Prescotts own this shithole.
Then you don't have to worry about me. Worry about yourself.
Do not analyze me! I pay people for that. Worry about yourself, Max Caulfield.
Take a step back, Nathan Prescott.
Oh man, you're telling me what to do?
Get away from her, dude!
Hey! Leave him alone!
Nobody tells me what to do! Not my parents, not the principal,
that.
Or that whore
right
in the bathroom!
Max? Chloe?
No way. You again.
Warren!
Go! Go! I got this!
Get in, Max!
Get your punk asses out of there now! Don't even try to run! Nobody! Nobody!
Man, Nathan Prescott is messed up and dangerous. This day never ends.
Oh, and thanks, Chloe. After 5 years, you're still Max Caulfield. Don't give me the guilty face. At least pretend you're glad to see me.
I am seriously glad to see you. Oh, and thanks, Chloe. It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Yes, it's been that kind of day. So what did that freak want with you?
Hopefully nothing after today. So, how do you know Nathan?
He's just another Arcadia asshole. Your friend really took a beat down for you.
Warren? Yeah, I owe him big time.
You're not the only one in debt. And you're already causing trouble.
I thought it would be quiet here. Feels so weird to be back.
So I guess Seattle sucked hard?
I guess. It was cool, but I felt kind of lonely, out of my league.
I would think you'd fit right in with the art school hipsters.
Right. You look like the cover of hipstergirl.com.
At least you're still a smartass.
That's why I'm here.
Please, girl. You came back for Blackwell Academy.
Only for Mark Jefferson. He was a pretty famous photographer in the 90s. I've always loved his work.
Those that can't do, teach. I'm glad you found a good reason to come back.
Don't you think I'm happy to see you?
No. You were happy to wait 5 years without a call or even a text.
I'm sorry. I know things were tough on you when I left.
How do you know? You weren't even here.
I didn't order my parents to move specifically to fuck you over, Chloe.
You've been at Blackwell for almost a month without letting me know. Enough said.
I just wanted to settle in first and not be such a shy, cliche geek. I totally would have contacted you.
I bet you don't use these sad excuses on Mr. Jefferson. Don't use them on me, Max.
Haven't heard that one in a while.
Not everything changes. Except my camera has officially taken a shit.
My step douche has a boatload of tools. Maybe you can fix it in my place.
I need very specific tiny tools.
Nerd alert. My stepdad has a fully stocked garage, and he actually is a tiny tool. Welcome home, Max. Come on in. Don't be shy.
The house still looks nice.
Home, shit, home. My room looks a bit different than the last time you saw it.
It's cool. At least we can chill out.
This isn't exactly my chill-out zone. My step-führer makes sure of that. Come in and close the door. Put on some music while I medicate.
This postcard is from Rachel Amber. This looks like a laundry bag. Old cardboard boxes. Oh, this is a flashback to youth. Our super secret closet lair. Chloe was always taller than me. We made her dad keep track of her height. Nothing but junk in this suitcase. Damn, Chloe does need a lot of money to get out of Arcadia. I wonder what Chloe keeps in here. There's the power strip. Hey, that TV used to be in the living room. Look at that. Chloe and her dad were so close. Houston, we have the power, but we need to find a disc to play. Too bad I can't stream any music from Chloe's laptop, but I love how funky and outdated it is. She even covered it in punk stickers because Chloe doesn't give a shit. Is this a desk or a storage space? I think this junk swallowed her discs. So it was Chloe who printed all those flyers. Chloe's trash overfloweth. Who'd have thunk Chloe wouldn't pay her parking tickets?
She does love trouble. Okay, Chloe, a metal box under the bed equals secret. I think this junk swallowed her discs.
So tell me, what does Max Caulfield do for fun now that she's a grown-up?
I don't feel grown up, just more confused as I get older. Especially after today.
Gee, thanks. I was hoping to hear something positive.
About me?
No, about me. Duh. I thought you'd at least be happy taking photos. Forget it.
Chloe totally changed her style. I barely recognized her. Hard to believe Chloe was my BFF just 5 years.
So tell me, what does Max Caulfield do for fun now that she's a grown-up?
I take photos. Of me, the world, everything. It may sound sad, but I have a blast.
It doesn't sound that sad.
I'm happiest when I've got a great image in my lens. I'm not lonely. Not afraid.
Now that's more inspiring. I don't feel so totally hopeless.
We had such a blast drawing these together. Houston, we have the power, but we need to find a disc to... She looks super happy. She looks super sad. She looks super stoned.
It's here, Max. Look a little harder.
And it reeks like dirty laundry. Gross.
Dude, you broke my glass snow dough. Thanks. Hey, give me that!
Sorry, I wasn't trying to be nosy. Obviously, she was a good friend.
It's putting it mildly.
That's Rachel Amber. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
Yeah, I put them up. She was my angel. After my dad died and you moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life.
Man, I had no idea.
Well, you never made much effort to find out. I was 14. We were best friends.
I never forgot. Even if I was an asshole and didn't keep in touch. But you had Rachel.
Rachel had my back. We were gonna kick the world's ass. You would laugh at how different we were. She wanted to be a star.
She looks like a model.
That was her plan. Our plan. Get the hell out of Bigfootville and into Los Angeles.
So what happened? Did your folks, your mom, try to stop you?
My mom was too busy hooked up with Sergeant Shithead.
I feel the love. Now, when did Rachel actually disappear?
6 months ago. She just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me.
How do you know she disappeared? Maybe she wanted to start a totally new life.
Unlike you, she would have told me, okay? Something happened to her.
I believe you. I'm just trying to get all deductive.
Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. Then poof.
And you haven't heard anything from her since?
Like everybody in my life. My dad, you, and Rachel. Gone. Can you put on some music now? Anyway, you can find tools to fix your camera in the garage.
Chloe, are you okay?
Sure, I'm awesome. I just want to blaze and be alone for a moment.
You can't go home again, said Thomas Wolfe. But here I am. These books have not been touched since the last decade. I see why. Nothing's changed. Except for me and Chloe. You tell me stories of the sea. And the ones you left behind. This must be Chloe's parents' room. Man, I am nosy today. I could do something to save it. And the ones we left behind. And the ones we left behind. Oh shit! Poor thing. I bet I could do something to save it. You've been resurrected, Birdie. Fly, be free. This is definitely Joyce's makeup. Chloe wouldn't use animal products. I wonder if Chloe is taking those pills. I hope she's okay. I like Chloe's new hair color. She's the opposite of shy. Of me.
You're somewhere I could go there, but I don't.
Doesn't look like the Price family is rolling in dough these days. Now this is the Chloe I remember. Always smiling and laughing. Not so much anymore.
Nach einer halben Ewigkeit sind wir endlich mal wieder auf Chloe getroffen. Max' alte Schul- und, ja, eigentlich Sandkastenfreundin. Was heißt eigentlich? Best Friends Forever! Haben uns ein bisschen mal in ihrem Zimmer umgeguckt, in ihrem Haus umgeguckt. Und schon einiges über sie erfahren. Oder was heißt erfahren? Neues erfahren, weil es ist ja einiges passiert in der Zeit, wo Max nicht mehr da war. Und ich habe jetzt einfach mal auch so ein bisschen den Tagebucheintrag mal aufgeschlagen, dass ich so ein bisschen, dass ich so mich ein paar Informationen nochmal dazu holen kann. Ja, ich gucke mich einfach mal weiter um, oder?
I haven't seen this place in 5 years. Seems like forever. Joyce still works at Two Wells Diner. Best damn burgers in Arcadia. I better get one soon. Brr. I can feel autumn pushing out the summer. William used to grill awesome burgers for us. I wonder if he was the last one to use this. We made this grave for Chloe's kitty. Poor Bongo. He never saw that car coming. That took Chloe and me the whole day to draw. It's almost invisible now. Truly want to do when you grow up.
Max, I'm already grown up. What about you?
Travel. That would be awesome. Explore the world, go far from here.
Far from me? Thanks a lot, dude.
Dude, you would totally come with me. I need a bodyguard for our adventures.
I would be like Lara Croft, except real. That would be majorly cool.
Totally. We'd have cars and boats and planes all over for instant escape. And no adults could tell us what to do.
Count me in. What would you do while I was bodyguarding you?
Maybe take pictures of our adventures. I would love to be a photographer. As if I ever could be.
What are you talking about? Max, you are a photographer. Your pictures could be in a museum. Someday they will. I believe in you.
Yum, that looks tasty. I do miss Joyce's cooking. If I took this picture, the deer would be standing on your ass.
Hey, I remember that stain. Chloe and I knocked over Joyce's wine bottle and we scrubbed forever, but it never came out. We got so busted. I guess they're aging, these books. I should be able to find the tools I need here. Check out the muscle car. Chloe's stepdad must be a gearhead. Look at all that food. That's like enough spam for 100 years. Poor little deer. It's not enough to kill you, they have to display your head. I wonder what's in those files up there. No password. Like it would help me find tools anyway. These are way too big. I need tiny tools for that camera. Wowzer, a map of Blackwell Academy. I wonder why. Should I switch this on? Decisions, what the? Chloe's stepdad actually installed cameras in the rooms? For reals? This guy has serious trust issues. Do Chloe and Joyce even know about this? Yes! Score! One of these guns is missing. I hope Chloe's stepdad isn't packing heat. Chloe's stepfather is this asshole from Blackwell? You've gotta be shitting me. Chloe's stepdad is head of security at Blackwell. He wants to put surveillance cameras all over the school? How paranoid can you get? Nothing. This is so lame. These are way too big. I need to... Shit! Butterfingers! K,
Kate Marsh, why the hell would he have pictures of her? Okay, this is getting totally weird. No need to go there now. Doesn't look like the Price family is rolling in dough these days. I love that they have the same old answering machine. And there's a message.
If you're listening, Pete was cruising home off duty and told me he saw you near that garbage dump. Now I've ordered... told you to stay away from that place. It's dangerous. And you got no idea what kind of scum are living out there. Stay away. I'm serious.
Chloe's stepfather is this asshole from Blackwell? You've gotta be shitting me. No password. Like it would help me find tools anyway. Nothing. This is so lame.
Ja, das war's auch leider schon mit Gameplay Nummer 3. Wir haben einiges an Informationen noch weiterhin über Chloe erfahren. Wir wissen jetzt, dass Chloe das Stiefkind von dem...
I'd love to go to Paris too. At this rate, they'll be lucky to get to Portland.
Ich habe vergessen, wie er heißt. Ich hab's nicht so mit Namen. Von unserem Hausschulpolizist, was auch immer, ist... dass er einige unserer Schüler spioniert, obwohl eigentlich bis jetzt ja nur eine Schülerin. Ich denke mal, dass der Computer, den wir gefunden haben, noch für den weiteren Verlauf relevant ist. Wir brauchen ein Passwort, also denke ich mal, dass wir den womöglich knacken werden. Aber ich glaube, ich setze mich mit Max erstmal auf die Couch, lasse ein paar Gedanken fließen und das Spiel abklingen. Ich verabschiede mich. Tschüssi!
Come on, open it, chicken. Hold on, and I'm not chicken.
Prove it. You drink first, Max.
No way. It was your idea, Chloe.
Whatever. Give me that bottle.
Well?
Tasty. Very tasty.
Here, I want a sip.
Sorry. This is not for kids.
Don't be greedy. Give me some.
Oh shit, the carpet! There's wine all over. What do we do now?
My parents are coming. Cover it up.